Good morning. My name is Sean Wilkinson, and I am a member of the St. Francis Choir. It is amazing how much I've learned during these past few years, but also very exciting how much I still have to learn. I am blessed to belong to a community that cares about connecting, and I'm grateful to be a performer of choral music. It helps me to appreciate life differently. Whether you sing in a group, whether it's a large choir like the Capitol Singers, or a smaller group, the act of collective singing causes your body to release endorphins. This hormone can help promote positive feelings, and for this I thank you. My word for today is sing. During my research for my word, I read up about Isaac Watts, who wrote over 600 hymns in the late 1700s, including When I Survey the Wondrous Cross and O God, Our Help in Ages Past. I read about Charles Wesley, who wrote almost 7,000 hymns, including Jesus, Lover of My Soul and Christ the Lord is Risen Today. One songwriter stands out in this time period, and her name is Fanny Crosby. This blind lady wrote over 9,000 hymns in her lifetime. She wrote To God Be the Glory, and the best known of all her hymns, which she wrote in 1873, was Blessed Assurance. Over 100 million copies of her work have been printed over the years, and some of her songs are still popular today, nearly 150 years later. This may be totally new information to some of you, and for others it probably seems like a trip down memory lane. The point I want us to see is that hymns we think of as traditional now were once modern and considered new songs. The challenge we may face in the 21st century is probably the same challenge Christians have faced in every century. How can we open the way for a new generation of Christian music? Music that will reach people with God's timeless message in the here and now. Nostalgia is nice, but is it what the church needs to offer? We don't come to church to just relive the good old days. Church is a place where we go to worship our God today. Our sermons and our music must make sense to people who need to know about God today. I personally believe the music of today must be testimonial music. It must be music that invites people to make a personal decision to serve Christ. This is the music I love because it speaks about personal relationships, just like the one I have with God my Father. A testimonial song that I love is Leonard Cohen's Hallelujah. Hallelujah was originally composed by singer-songwriter Leonard Cohen and released in 1984, the year I matriculated. In Hebrew, the word hallelujah means to sing and rejoice in praising God. The song by Leonard Cohen is a bitter lament about love and loss. Cohen, adept in scripture, simply taps the human condition described in the Bible in order to provide counsel to the brokenhearted. Through Cohen's word imagery, including references to some of the most notorious women in the Bible, we find that the word hallelujah can mean so much more than just its religious context. Hallelujah, the song teaches us. It is a refrain worthy of times of celebration, of mourning, of regret, of catharsis and reconciliation. Cohen's song tells a story of broken love, true love remembered and mourned, guilt, penance, and of finding peace. The song's constant refrain, Hallelujah, takes the listener through a journey of pain, joy, suffering, and celebration. This is a journey that all people know, and some people know very well, especially during this COVID pandemic. If you listen carefully to the lyrics, you will hear the references to the following scriptures. 1 Samuel 16 verse 14 to 23, which talks of how the lowly shepherd boy David and future king of Israel was summoned to play his lyre and sing to King Saul. That relief would come to King's evil spirits, which we can assume was a form of terrible depression. The song also refers to David, the former shepherd, and then when he became king, and his stolen love, Bathsheba. This is found in 2 Samuel 11 verses 2, where it talks of David's fall from God's favor to his eventual restoration to God as one of Israel's most famous kings. In Judges 16 verses 4, it talks of Samson's tragic romances and his love for Delilah, who betrayed him by telling his enemies of how his amazing strength was apparently obtained through the length of his hair. The rest of the song's meaning is vague, but numerous interpretations have been garnered. However, its breathtaking beauty is unquestionable. Cohen's lyrics are haunting and filled with lamentation, especially when he sings it. So, members and friends of St. Francis, what song do you love to sing? Which song do you believe can be your testimony or bear witness to your relationship with Jesus? Be blessed, my brothers and sisters, and always remember to sing. Sing and rejoice in praising God. Sing to tell us your story. Sing your song. Sing as you praise our Savior all the day long. Playing us out today is Pentatonix, an a cappella group singing my favorite song, Hallelujah.